Hi, first grade. We are back for another social science lesson. And the last few days we have learned about Abraham Lincoln. Today we're going to switch to learning about George Washington. And we will start by watching a brain pop about him in this video. And then the next video, we will continue working on that presidential poster that we have been working on. Okay. So we are going to go ahead and start with watching the brain pop junior. Here we go.
Giving a report on George Washington, the first president of the United States. What was George Washington like when he was young? George Washington was born on February 22, 1732, in Virginia. Virginia was one of the 13 colonies, which were ruled by the King of Great Britain. George Washington was taught at home by his father and older brother. His favorite subject was math. When George Washington was 17 years old, he worked as a surveyor. It was his job to keep track of people's land and make maps of different areas. Later, he decided to join the army. How did George Washington become president? Great Britain and France were fighting over land in North America. George Washington fought on Great Britain's side and led soldiers to fight against the French army. Because he worked as a surveyor, he could draw maps and help soldiers find their way. People respected Washington, and later he was elected as a leader in Virginia's government. Washington and other colonists believed it was unfair they had to pay taxes or money to the British government, but did not get to choose their leaders. People agreed that the colonists should separate from Great Britain. In 1775, colonists and British soldiers started fighting, and the American Revolutionary War began. Washington was chosen to lead the Continental Army, which was the army of the colonies. On Christmas Day in 1776, Washington led soldiers across the Delaware and won an important battle against the British. Later, he and his army camped at Valley Forge, Pennsylvania for 6 months. It was freezing cold and they didn't have enough food. Many soldiers died. Washington encouraged his troops and helped the colonists believe that fighting for the country's freedom was worth it. The American Revolutionary War finally ended in 1781. Later, in 1787, the Constitution of the United States was written and signed. The Constitution is the set of laws of the United States that explains how the government should be organized and run. The Constitution gives people the right to elect or vote for their leaders. The people elected George Washington to be first president of the United States. What did George Washington do as president? Washington had a big job to do. He chose people with different opinions to help him run the country and be a fair leader. During Washington's presidency, the states passed the Bill of Rights, which are the first 10 amendments to the Constitution. The Bill of Rights describes certain freedoms, such as the right to free speech and religion. Washington set many precedents or examples for future presidents to follow. After Washington was elected, people wondered what to call him. Some people wanted to call him Your Majesty or Your Highness, as though he were a king. But Washington thought a president shouldn't have too much power. So he preferred to be called Mr. President. So Washington set a precedent. The executive leader of the United States will always be known as Mr. or Ms. President. After Washington served his first term as president, he was elected to another term. People wanted him to serve a third term, but he said no.
Oh, no, no.
He thought that different people should have a chance to lead the country. He set a precedent that presidents should only run for two terms, for a total of 8 years. After he stepped down as president, Washington returned to his home in Mount Vernon, Virginia. He died on December 14th, 1799. Because Washington helped start the United States, people call him the father of our country. You can find his face on the quarter and on the dollar bill. There are also monuments that honor his memory and schools that are named after him. Plus, our nation's capital is called Washington, D.C. And of course, we have the state of Washington. Washington was a very popular president, and there are many stories about him. But some stories are folk tales or legends that have grown over time. You can learn all about his life by the journals, letters, and notes he left behind.
All right. Awesome first grade. Tune into our next video so we can learn even more about George Washington. See you there. Bye.